Welcome back to The Layover, where you get that piping hot tea, your celebrity news, your gossips, all of that. You name it. You saw that one. Of course, you know I'm Desiree.
And I'm Natasha.
And we're here to talk about music festivals.
Yes.
Because to me, this is the season.
The season is upon us, yeah.
Now, have you ever been to a music festival?
I have not. I want to. Coachella is definitely at the top of my list, but Coachella is so expensive.
It's so expensive.
You gotta save up for it.
It sells out like 4 years before the. It's just crazy. Yeah. I mean, I just don't get it. But if you can't make it to Coachella, there's so many.
Yeah.
There are so many. There's Made in America, Philly. Who, Jay-Z, you said, owns that one?
That's produced by Jay-Z, and I think he's actually performing this time. I saw the lineup. I can't remember every single artist, but it's definitely something that if you're in Philly, you want to go.
Right.
Like, it's going to be lit.
Then they have Broccoli City Fest in D.C. Do they have something here in Atlanta?
I know for Atlanta, there's a few. There's the One Music Festival. I think that's maybe around August or September. And then coming up this month, there's the Funk Fest at Wolf Creek. I wanted to go to that, but them coins ain't about right. I wanted to see Roe James and Erykah Badu. They're going to be there May 19th. I think that's a Friday. And then I don't know who's going to be there Saturday, but Sunday is going to be kind of like old school with Babyface, SWV, En Vogue. So it's going to be a good little turn up for the ATL.
That would be. Now, what would be your ideal festival experience? I know for me, you go first.
Okay, my ideal festival experience, since I kind of work in the ticketing industry, I just want it to be a smooth process from beginning to end. As far as me purchasing my tickets, getting into the venue, everything being organized, the actual event staff being nice. And just as far as the performers, I just want high energy, like, what's the guy's name? Bryson Tiller. I love his music, but I saw him perform. I'm like, oh my God, this is horrible. He has a terrible stage presence. So I'm kind of like neo soul music. So I would love to see like Jasmine Sullivan, Lauryn Hill, Erykah Badu. Like I just want to chill and just Jill Scott. I cannot leave out Jill Scott. I have to see Jill Scott. So yeah.
In that case, speaking of festivals, you need to hit up Essence Music Festival.
Essence Music Festival. It's free.
And all of those people are always there. Like, when I've worked in the past few years, it is a great experience. So R&B, pop, neo soul, that kind of thing is your thing. That's where you need to be. I can't think of any others, but there's so many.
It is.
And the
it's
thing
a lot.
About it is, if they weren't so expensive, well, I guess, I don't know why they're so expensive, especially Coachella. I'm not really sure. I guess, well, if Beyonce is pregnant and still charging them $1 million.
And she still got paid.
And she still got paid. And she didn't show up, yeah. And she knew she wasn't. So I guess that's why they're charging so much. But in my ideal festival experience, I want it to be super lit. But I mean, I still want to feel safe. I don't know how that works. I don't want to feel like, okay, if I look away for a second, my purse is gone.
Right.
I don't know if that's even possible. But I want it to be super lit. I want it to be just vibes. Good music, like you said, upbeat music.
Good music, good people, good drinks.
Yes. But you know, it's like these music festival flyers, they'll have the biggest. And I'm like, golly, and then they get smaller. And it's like a little eye test at the eye doctors. The very bottom is like that one indie artist that has. No, I'm like, I don't want to be that person if I was a musician. I mean, and I really don't want to see that person either, to be honest. But they could be a nice little intro. But to
they
me,
gotta
I don't,
start somewhere, yeah.
Yeah, they do. But not at the festival I'm paying so much money for. Because then it gets to the point where you want to see those headliners that you've been waiting for 8 hours swaying to any artist that you... I mean, they're great on SoundCloud, but they're not that great on stage yet. And then I'm like, oh, no, I need this to be upbeat, good food, and just great vibes. I don't know what Coachella, do you know why they always wearing like the Native American garb?
I think when it comes to Coachella, it's just like, besides the music, it's just like a big fashion event. Like, you see a lot of celebrities just wearing weird...
Fringe and feathers.
Rihanna, she had this like one piece unitard. It was like sparkly, and then she had some shorts over it. It was really nice for Rihanna.
So a lot of people wear a lot of eccentric outfits
when it comes to Coachella, just to stand out for whatever reason.
Well, that's good to know. I definitely want to get into that music festival scene because it seems like it would be right up my alley. I love music. I love the vibe of performances. If you can actually sing live. A lot of celebrities cannot.
I love Rihanna. She can't sing live. I would never, ever
she can.
Pay to see her live.
I would not. Who else? There's just a few others. But, I mean, if you need more information, check out eonculture.com. There will be a list of the greatest music festivals with prices and their website so you can know more about it. Do not forget to like, comment, subscribe, share it, interact with us so we'll know what it is that you're thinking. We need to be able to produce better quality content, but we don't know if we have the audience or what you guys like.
And speak up.
We need to know those things.
Yes, so again, thank you guys so much for tuning in to The Layover. This is your spot to get a quick dose of entertainment news and celebrity gossip. We keep it short and quick because we all got other ish to do. And until the next layover, y'all, peace. Peace.